everybody, how's it going? Grohlvana here. Welcome to another episode of Skyrim's Hidden Treasures. Let's do this. So we're actually doing Pilgrim's Trench, and I'll show you on the map where it is. This is Irzgamir's tomb or whatever. This is the Tower Stone. This is Ingvild, and this is Winterhold, and it's right about here. And from what I can tell from reading online, this place is actually underwater, and it's like a whole bunch of ships, and that's definitely a Skyrim's Hidden Treasure. So let's go check it out. So first, I'm going to equip Volsung, which is a mask, a Dragon Priest mask that lets you breathe underwater, among other things. I'm going to equip this so that I can breathe underwater, of course, and we're going to go find this Pilgrim's Trench and see if it holds any treasure or secrets or whatever. I'm surprised this actually isn't related to any quests or anything, because this is really cool, and I'm surprised I've never even heard about this. Let's try and go to the location. Oh, that's cool too. So wow, it actually doesn't even activate unless you go to the bottom where it is. Good thing we brought that Volsung mask or whatever. So we're right above it right now, and like I said, this is where it is on the map. Let's take a trip down and see what we can find. You sort of was able to see it on the surface there. Yeah, it kind of sucks because you can't really see it that well once you're underwater, but let's see if we can get a good view of it if we're looking down at the surface, because it's, you know, Skyrim sort of does that weird thing where you can see underwater. I'll try and show you what I mean. I don't know if I'll be able to do it or not. What I mean is, if you're like barely on the surface here, you can sort of see what's underwater as if you weren't in the actual water itself. I guess it's not allowing me to do that. Oh well, let's go check out Pilgrim's Trench. So I guess it's a trench in the ocean, meaning that it's the hell, it says I can catch salmon. Oh, there's just a whole bunch of salmon running around. It's like, it's called a trench because this is like at a deeper location than other parts of the trench itself. So this seems to be the first ship. Let's take a look at it. We don't have much here. There's a crate, which I thought was a chest, but it's not. Anything in here? No, it's gonna be hard to explore this whole location just because everything's submerged. We have another piece of a ship here. We actually can't attack underwater, so hopefully there's no slaughter fish or anything. I don't think we're going to have much trouble, though. This would be really, really, really hard to explore if you didn't have a water-breathing mask or anything. We got some barnacles and a chest over here. Let's see what's inside of it. Nothing really. Some refined moonstone. Anything down here? Just a salmon. I guess he made this his home. I don't really know if there can be anything down here, honestly, just because, you know, I don't think they could put a skill book down here because it would kind of float in the water or anything, really. We have another chest. Some gold and some resist shock. That seems to be it for this one. I wonder how many ships there are. I think someone suggested this, and they said, a couple people suggested this location. They said there was like four ships. So we saw a broken half of one, and this is another one. I don't want to miss any, but I don't see any around here. This is the third one. Let's see if we have anything on here of note. Yeah, I'm thinking this is just going to be really a location that's unique. There's nothing really going to be unique about it, just because, like I said, you can't really place anything underwater and have it stay, so I don't think there's going to be anything that, you know, we could loot or anything. Nevertheless, it's a cool location, though, obviously, because it's a bunch of sunken ships. That actually might be it, unless there's another ship somewhere that I'm missing. I really wish they put more stuff underwater, you know, because it... What's the point of water breathing, really? I can't think of really any situation that I actually needed to use a water breathing item other than this, and there's really nothing to find on the floor of the ocean, so I don't know. I really wish they put more stuff underwater. I know in Oblivion there was a lot of stuff, especially there was one, I think it was a Assassin's or a Dark Brotherhood quest where you needed to go through a hole in the water and to kill like a mage in a tower or something. And there was like a huge giant slaughterfish at the bottom of it. I think that's going to do it for Pilgrim's Trench, actually. Definitely a cool location. Like I said, nothing really of note. There's all these floating planks and stuff. I wonder if they move if I run into them. They sure do. Sweet. Just an update on my computer situation. Everything is pretty much shipped except for a couple things, which they actually probably shipped today. I've actually already gotten the mouse, the keyboard, the operating system, and the speakers in the mail. I have those with me right now. Everything should be coming within a couple of days. The last things I'm waiting on really is the power supply and the motherboard, and then I should be good to go to build it. So, thank you all for watching this episode of Skyrim's Hidden Treasures. That was Pilgrim's Trench. There it is. I don't think we can clear it. My name is Grohlvana, and as always, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.